you asked, I promised. I'm bringing you color correcting for the mature woman. Actually, this is color correcting for any woman. If you want to know how to color correct, you've never done it before, it's intimidating, we're going to do this in this video right now. So in my last video, I showed this gem, and it's the color correcting palette from NYX, and so many of you had said, I'm intimidated by this, I don't know how to use this, what should I do? And I'm going to demonstrate this for you so that you can see what all these colors in action are like. But I also want to, before we start into that part of the video, I want to show you something with color correcting with the LA Girl pigments that I did talk about as well. Now, it's kind of a no-brainer as to making it lighter or darker. You use the white that I talked about. They have a white in this formula. They also have a white in a thinner, more luminous formula. This one's matte. So if you needed to do that, then you know you could go ahead and lighten it. And then NYX has the dark one. And I don't even know if I talked about this in my NYX video, but this is basically just called dark. And this is a very thin formula. And in the video, I will show you that I mix this into my foundation to darken up my foundation just a little bit because it was a little bit too light. So what I want to show you about the blue, I'm using this right here. I don't know why Physicians Formula can't get away from orange, but they can't. So this is their Butter Believe It foundation. And this one you're going to see is orange on me. Well, I don't even know if it's going to show that well on camera, but it is orange on me. And it just, it drives me crazy that this is so orange. And what are you going to do? You know, you're going to throw the bottle away. You're going to take it back. What are you going to do? I'm going to show you it right there so you can see. And then this middle part, because I squoze a lot in there, I'm going to take my mix and medium from LA Girl. This is a new bottle I got because my old bottle was so gross. So I'm gonna have to take a second here. Oh, I think I overdid it. See how much I put in there? I think that's way too much, but I have a lot of foundation on here. So now I'm just mixing it into the foundation. It's gonna change that foundation, especially if it's orange or yellow. It's gonna start to look a little bit, you're gonna go, well, that's like too sallow for me, or it has a dull look for me. And that's true, it will do that. Now see, I have to put a little bit more in here because it's so orange that it didn't even do that. So see how much I put in there? Another couple of drops. This is a lot of foundation, you guys. Just use a little bit to begin with so you can really get the feel for it. But this was a lot of foundation that I squeezed onto my hand for some weird reason. Okay, this should show you exactly what I'm talking about. So the one that is right here, oh, I'm hoping this shows up on camera. The one that is right here is the one that I put the drops in, the blue drops in. And then right here is the orange. So that's what that does. It turns it into a cool tone. You just keep mixing until you get what you want it to. I do it on the back of my hand. So again, here is the one that's not color corrected, orange all the way. This one just looks a little bit more muted. It looks a little bit more on, it has that blue undertone. You can tell almost immediately. That is what those, that mix in medium is all about. And I definitely wanted to show you that part of the color correcting, but I do want to get into showing you how to color correct on your face. I hope that you do enjoy this. It is really, really easy. Don't worry about picking all the colors and doing all the colors on your face. That's just what I'm showing. So I hope that you do enjoy this video. Give it a thumbs up if you do. Let's get into color correcting so you can see how it's done on this face and how I get this look in the end. Before we get into the actual color correcting with a bunch of colors, what I also want to tell you is the discoloration that is above your eyes or on your eyelid, you want to tackle that too, because what happens is not only is that going to darken up your makeup look, but it's also going to not make your eyeshadow look as bright or as light. So if you're very fair complected like I am, that's going to make your eyes look even darker, and that's not what you want. So I'm actually trying for the first time the P. Louise base. This is an eyeshadow that you can buy on Morphe.com. I think you can buy it on Amazon as well. I really like the consistency of this so far. A little tiny bit goes a long way. So let me show you how small of an amount I'm putting on there. I am just going to completely go across the eyelids. And that will give an instant brightness all by itself without any color corrector. And I think that's important. You know, as we age, it gets darker around our eyes, and We just need that area all brightened up. That worked in really easily and I am liking it so far. Try to get clear in there in the inner corner with that because it's going to take the discoloration out of that area as well. So the thinking behind color correcting is that you color balance with the color that's across the color wheel in an that is opposite of that color. So if you have purple, opposite of purple would be yellow. If you have blue, opposite of blue would be orange. Here comes the pups. If you have redness, that opposite would be green, and so on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to show you the ones that I have in my collection, the ones that I've used, that I've tried, that work pretty good for me. The first one you've seen a lot, and that is the Pixie by Petra. This is quite kind of a light peach. I think it's called Brightening Peach. It's quite nice. It's a good color for me. It works out really well. And then the next one that I have is from Catrice. This is a little bit lighter than that one, so it's good for me in the winter time. This is called the Camouflage Wake Up Effect, and it has a very it has a consistency that's just a tiny bit thicker than the Pixie by Petra. The Pixie is my perfect consistency. It's not too dry, but it's not so emollient that it's going to make my concealer move around. So it's kind of that really happy medium for me. And right here, you can see how light that one is by Catrice. Very, very light. The next one is from Tarte. This is the CC Under Eye Corrector. And this one is a really light one too. This is the light medium one. I've hit pan on this. It's not hard to hit pan on these because it is quite emollient and there's not a lot in there. But you can see that that is almost identical to the Catrice one. So those two are very much alike. And then I have the LA Girl Pro, which I talked about in my video all about LA Girl. This one is in peach. This is a little bit thicker of a formula, and it's a little bit better, I believe, for oily skin because it's going to hold up a little bit better. It's a little bit darker as well. I do like the delivery system as well. You can just, instead of putting your finger in there, you just kind of paint it on. And then lastly, I have the Charlotte Tilbury. This one is the one that I've been reaching for a lot simply because it's a darker color. I want to try and get my hands on the Pixie by Petra and the one that is the a little bit darker. I think it's an apricot colors. So I want to try and get my hands on that. The Charlotte Tilbury and the Tarte are the two that come in a lot of different colors. Now, if you are somebody, that's not true. Also, the LA Girl comes in a bunch of different colors. If you are someone that is deeper skin toned, medium to deep, you can play around and find one of these that might work really well for you. And if you're very, very deep, even red really counteracts darkness. And you might have seen that way back in the day on Instagram and YouTube. People were wearing red lipstick under there. I don't suggest that you do lipstick, but they do have a red in this. And they do have a darker apricot color, I think, and an orange color. So you might think about getting those. So this is the one from LA Girl in the peach that I'm going to use for my under eyes. Why don't I use a yellow under there if it's supposedly purple circles? I've tried yellow. But these are almost like bluish purple. So the peach works so much better for me. And the other thing is my skin tone, it works better for me too, in just giving that little bit of brightness. And so it's not going to look muddy or anything like that under my eyes. It's gonna look really bright. And I don't wait to go in and just tap that across. Like I said, this is really good if you're a little bit more oily. It will not, you know, move around as much as maybe some of the other ones that are a little bit more emollient. And in the summertime when I sweat underneath my eyes, it does a really good job. Can you see how that just immediately did a great brightening? I will go and I will just dot this ever so slightly right there on the line. The line is where I get the deepest color right there, and I'm just patting that out as well very lightly. For all of the other colors, I'm going to use this palette. You asked me to use this palette because a lot of you said, oh, I have the Stila palette too. I forgot about that. I didn't pull it out for this video, but I'll see if I can throw it up in a picture. The Stila has one of these as well, one of the color corrector cream palettes. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to try some of these other colors. This green right here is good for redness. So around my nose right here, a lot of women like me get a little bit of hormonal, like little blood vessels through there. So kind of dot that in there. Now with the green, be very careful because you can get carried away. All we want to do is just lightly counteract the redness. And as you can see across my cheeks right here, I'm going to take some more of it and I'm just going to dot it across the redness across my cheeks. And then on this one, now these dark spots that are out here, those are going to be a little bit trickier. And I want to show you how the peach works with those. So again, you can choose the peach or you can choose the yellow. Because of my complexion, I'm going to choose the peach. And this one right here is just a little bit darker, so I'm going to go ahead and use it. I'm using the palette instead of what I used underneath my eyes. Two reasons I want to show you. And the other reason is this works a little bit better because it's a little bit more emollient underneath foundation. So here are my bad spots. These are my acne scars, and they're also sunspots, so I'm just wanting to cover those up. And I have them on both sides, age spots. I shouldn't call them sunspots, they truly are age spots, although I was the atypical sun worshiper like we all were in the 80s 70s 80s and 90s. Oh my goodness, if we only knew, right? Now I can still see that I am having a little bit of breakthrough right through here with the redness. So you're going to think this is weird too, but I'm going to take a little bit of the yellow and I'm going to put that on top of the green just to hide that a little bit more, just right in here. And I'm going to blend them together, the peach, the green, and the yellow. I know I look like a clown right now, so I'm just blending those together. I'm really trying to hide these dark freckles that I have. I can't completely hide them, and I don't really care to hide them completely, but I do want to show you as much as I can on this tutorial how to use these colors. Okay, so then we're talking about the purple. What would the purple be for? It's for a sallow complexion. So if you have a complexion that's very dull, like my complexion isn't dull, it's red, it's ruddy red, and so I have that problem. But let's say that you do have that problem. Let's go down here onto my décolleté, and even though this is kind of red, around here it's a little bit dull. If I put this purple in this little dip right here by my neck, that's going to brighten that area up. And I just kind of experimented one day and found that this really did help because it was casting such a shadow through there. And I was like, well, that doesn't look very good. So I kind of just put that on there. And then I also have the bands from my neck wrinkles. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a little bit of yellow on those. So this looks crazy, I know, but this is fun to do if you're somebody that is bothered with one of these things. Now, I am not saying that you need to go in and do all of this, because on the days that I'm doing my makeup, I use the peach corrector and I actually put it all over these problem areas. If I'm wanting to get an extremely perfected or flawless look, then I'll go over with the other colors. But I'm showing you these because your concern might not be what mine is, which is a lot of darkness. And the peach helps to brighten that up. You might have that sallowness. You might have that need to cover with the green a little bit of that redness. Or you might be somebody that really needs the yellow because of your coloring. You definitely do not need to use this whole palette. Pick and choose. One day you might need the green. Your face might be a lot more ruddy. One day you might need the peaches. You might need to, you know, brighten up under the eyes. You can choose whatever works for you, and that's the great thing about color correcting. If you've been with me for very long, you've seen my video on the best foundation technique ever and how to get your foundation to last a lot longer and to use less foundation. And that is my most popular video, and I'm really proud of that. So what I'm going to do next is going to seem counterintuitive for those of you that haven't seen that video. I will make sure that I link it down below. So I'm going to put powder on top of all of this. I put primer on first. That's probably what I forgot to tell you. I did use my marshmallow primer from NYX, and then I put all of that color corrector on. Now what I'm wanting to do is I'm wanting to make sure that all of that gets set down so that it doesn't move around with the foundation that I'm about to put on. By the way, I did use my Flower Beauty Light Illusion Powder, and I have porcelain. I could probably use light right now, but it really doesn't matter because it's going underneath foundation. The next thing we're gonna try is the Morphe. This is the Filter Effect Soft Focus Foundation. Mine is in medium 12. I do feel like it's a tiny bit too light for me. And I'm gonna put just a dropper full of this, not a dropper full, two drops of this NYX that is the dark. It helps foundations be different, a different color. And this one just happens to help it be a little bit darker. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just gonna dot this all over. As I am covering my face, you can see that that color corrector just disappears. It is so pretty the way that it just goes away. I mean, you're not going to show up anything. There's not going to be any color corrector that is right on top. It's just so beautiful if you use a light hand. Now, I'm not saying that if you're a deeper skin gal that you don't need to use more, because you do. You know, lighter hand would mean for a very fair person like I am. But if you're a deeper gal, go for it. Use the, you know, use the deeper colors. Don't work them in as much. Try to make the edges very blended, which you want to do no matter which one you're using. But I want to show you, isn't that pretty? Isn't it beautiful on my skin? It just hides everything. There's a little bit of redness down here, but keep in mind, I didn't work down here except for in the hollow right here, which as you can tell, that looks a little bit brightened, and nothing looks green, nothing looks yellow. It just looks like a more perfected canvas than I would have had if I had just used the foundation without any color corrector under there. I love the way that this does. And yes, by the way, I did do my eyes while I was off from camera. And then for concealer, I'm using the Morphe 2 Hide and Peak Concealer. This is supposed to be like a light to medium coverage, but so I'm going to use very, very small amount. And I am just going to go ahead and I'm gonna put it there, and I'm gonna put it on the edge, and then I'm gonna connect the two. And it's going to cover so well because I already have the color corrector on. So I did this eye. I'm going to take this one, and I'm just gonna dot it over here. This is a nice concealer. Like I said, this is not a full coverage. It's going on very lightly, and it's covering up beautifully. I'm bringing it out here on this edge where it gets really dark. So I'm just going to take my Becca powder, and I'm gonna put it on my big brush that I got from Ulta, and I'm gonna set those under eyes. I have gotten into the habit of setting my under eyes with powder, you guys, but only because it's this Becca powder. And this brush deposits such a light amount that I can go across it and make it look perfected without it ever looking cakey at all. So this is the final look. I think it turned out really pretty, and especially the skin. The skin is the star of the show because we've taken away all of those imperfections before we put foundation on. And like I showed you, you could go without foundation. You could just do a tint to even out things a little bit, and it would be absolutely gorgeous. I chose a foundation that I'm trying out right now from Morphe, but it is beautiful, and it just looks really, really good. And it doesn't disrupt your makeup at all. What goes on top of those color correctors, especially since you're dusting that powder, it doesn't disrupt the makeup at all. So I hope that you did enjoy seeing how to use your color correctors. Please give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. Thanks so much for hanging with me and spending a little bit of your time. I love you to death, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye, friends.